What's up, guys? Welcome to Daily Dose of Reddit. This is your host, Zach, and today's subreddit is r/entitledparents.
This story's called, How Dare You Let My Son Handle Toxic Substances?
So now that I'm at home and the hardships of the day are behind me, I can finally sit and just marvel at the absolute audacity of entitled breeders around us, and the ridiculousness of one of them with her spawn that I came across. I have a love for my hair being fantastic colors, the more colorful and fanciful the better. As anyone else who has hair like mine would know, having hair this way costs a pretty penny. For years I went and had it done professionally, and boy did it cost me. I soon realized that if I wanted to keep this up, I would have to learn how to do it myself. With much trial and error, I finally perfected doing it on my own. To get top products without having to order online, I started buying my supplies at a store specializing in those products. Today, I went to restock on supplies, and I ran into a nightmare of a child and entitled mother. In these stores, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of supplies that are dangerous and deadly if handled the wrong way. I was picking out what I needed and had let the store associate know that I did not require her assistance. While I went about my business, in walks a Karen and her demon spawn. Immediately, the associate asked if she needed assistance. With an ah and a sniff with her nose upturned, she scoffed a rude,
"No, I know what I'm doing."
With barely a glance back to her spawn, she said,
"Mama needs some stuff for her hair. Just go look around."
This child was about 7 or 8, and he immediately started running around the store looking at everything. For a minute or so, everything was fine. I grabbed my dye and hair leave-in products and slowly made my way to the register. The associate smiled and asked if I was ready to check out. Before I could open my mouth, Mega Karen, without even looking at the associate, started snapping her fingers and said,
"Lady, lady, I need you over here."
She stopped, turned and tried to tell Karen that she was going to check me out and would go help her in a bit, but was immediately cut off with a,
"No, I can't find
insert product.
Don't you have it?"
with a grimace. She once again tried to say she would check me out, but of course, Karen was determined to get help immediately. Once I realized she was going to be difficult, I told the girl working that it was okay, I could wait. I was gonna look at nail polish anyway. I wasn't, but I've been in that position working retail and I knew this cooter was gonna be ridiculous. While the Karen and the girl were talking and looking for whatever that cooter wanted, this little demon had grabbed a hand basket and he started grabbing products and throwing them into the basket. Combs, caps, hair twists, you name it. He then got on his hands and knees going along the floor and started playing with the big tubs of bleach powder, using them as drums, taking combs and hair chopsticks, using them as drumsticks, to pound away, creating his own personal little concert. The girl asked him to stop, saying that the bleach powders were dangerous to play with. Of course, Karen told her he wasn't hurting anything and it was keeping her goblin entertained. Associate let it go and kept on helping Karen. Her kid slowly kept dumping more stuff into the basket, creating his own small hair product mountain. Then he stood and reached for the hair straighteners and grabbing a few, I thought he would do the same and add to his growing mound. Nope, he started opening the packages. At this point, I had been content to stare at him while I waited for Karen to let the poor girl come check me out, but then the little turd grabbed 2 cheese straighteners, probably deciding they made good drumsticks, and knowing these bad boys can go up to over $100, I walked up to him and said,
"Oh no, sweetie, these are really expensive. Don't open them, that would be bad." Y'all, Karen zeroes in on me while I'm talking to her semen demon and snaps,
"Don't talk to my child. Who do you think you are telling what he can and can't do?"
I was a bit startled at this reaction. "I'm sorry, I don't mean to be rude, but those are very expensive." She didn't even let me finish what I was saying and continued to screech at me at an octave I'm sure only my dog could hear.
"How dare you? Get away from my son, you wow!
Racist term.
Freaking cooter, he can touch and play with whatever he likes."
I was seriously so shocked by her reaction that I didn't know what to say and I just kind of stuttered and Before it could get any further, the associate jumped in and said,
"I'm sorry, ma'am,"
facing Karen.
"Why don't I just check her out real quick, then we can finish looking for whatever it is you need."
She turned to me with desperate eyes and I just agreed. I wanted to be out of there and walk away from imbecile Karen and her overgrown cream pie as soon as possible. Karen huffed out a little.
"Well, fine, but do it fast."
The girl and I do our little song and dance of checking out, asking for my store member card, yada yada.
yada yada, while the mentally incompetent Karen huffed and mumbled under her breath about being her this, should know her place that, as I was finishing up paying, using card, punching in pin, the little freaking devil spawn decides now is a good time to open a bucket of bleaching powder and stick his face and hands in the bag to play with such powder, and then starts screaming and hacking and crying about how it hurts and his eyes are burning, blah blah blah. The girl was bagging my stuff as this happens, and Karen goes full on Megatron entitled Beach of a Screeching Harpy and starts screaming and yelling at this poor associate about, how could you let him handle that product? Why didn't you say something? How could you be so careless, etc., etc. Poor girl's eyes were as big as dinner plates and could barely stammer out a word, let alone a defense for herself about it. I am ashamed to admit that I ducked out. My anxiety had heightened to such a degree I could hear my pulse roaring in my ears. I grabbed my stuff, now done paying for it, and jumped ship. I feel so bad that I left that poor girl alone to deal with that demented, bleached blonde, I want to speak to your manager, haircut, rabbit, Tyrannosaurus Rex of an entitled mother, and just booked it. I didn't want to deal with any of that, nor witness it, but I just cannot believe that actually happened. I feel terribly guilty for leaving that poor girl to fend for herself. I swear to God, it's something you would never think could possibly happen, because it's a how can any person be that horrible kind of thing, you know? I'm still in utter disbelief over the entire situation. I'm sorry, I'm screwed up for this, but I just can't help but laugh about that kid. Sticking his head in a freaking bucket of bleach powder. That should be in the subreddit r/kidsarefippinstupid. That subreddit is so funny. Oh my gosh, and this, I know it's dangerous, that kid could have died, but honestly, it's so dumb. This story's called Plane Ride to Orlando with Entitled Mother and Entitled Kid. A few years ago, my sister and I were on a flight to Orlando, so clearly there are a lot of families on the plane. There were also some people who appeared to be traveling for business but had been sentenced to coach. I happened to be sitting in a row in front of a very patient man, an entitled Karen, and her little entitled Caleb, who was about 6. The Caleb was in between his mom and the patient man, and the patient man had the window seat. The mom made sure little Caleb had a full introduction to the patient man before the plane took off. The cast, patient man,
entitled mom,
entitled kid.
The flight was from Salt Lake City straight to Orlando, so about 4 hours. And this entitled kid starts right up at takeoff and asks patient man for some of the sandwich he brought on the plane. I could tell this whole scenario was gonna be good, so I left my earphones out. Patient man chuckled like entitled kid was kidding, and he probably didn't know what the flip ass to do. Entitled mom said,
he can have some as long as there's no mayo. He's allergic to eggs.
My sister, who was also listening with great interest, and I looked at each other, wondering if we were both hearing things, because no one would say that, right? Right? Patient man said, oh shoot, it's got mayo on it. Entitled kid said,
oh well, I can just have chips then.
Judging by what we heard, the kid reached over and grabbed the man's bag of chips. The poor patient man, I am sure he had no idea what to do. Entitled kid hands the bag of chips over to the entitled mom, and she opens the bag for the kid. Doesn't bat an eyelash, like it's a regular occurrence for her kid to steal food from someone he has known for 20 minutes. A few minutes later, entitled kid asks patient man for some gum. Patient man said, I don't have any. The ever observant entitled kid says,
you're chewing some.
Patient man said, it's my last piece. Entitled kid replied,
no, it's not. I saw you put a package in your backpack before we got on the plane. Mommy, he won't let me have gum.
Entitled mom said,
I guess he isn't very good at sharing.
Patient man, who I am sure has qualified for sainthood, gets his backpack out from under the seat in front of him, which was mine, to get entitled kid some gum, possibly hoping it will keep entitled kid's mouth busy for a while. Patient man takes the opportunity to take his tablet out. My sister's trying to watch all this from the seat next to me because we are genuinely curious as to how all this is gonna play out. Much more entertaining than Delta's in-flight entertainment at this point. Entitled kid sees the tablet and nearly craps himself with excitement.
His entitled mom sees the tablet too and tells the hapless, patient man,
"Oh good, that will keep him happy for a couple of hours."
She then puts on her sleep mask, headphones, and her freaking neck pillow, this is 10 a.m. by the way, and tells patient man to not let entitled kid have anything with caffeine when the flight attendant comes by for drinks. Patient man must have had his own kids because I don't know how he put up with that crap otherwise. Anyway, patient man ended up buying a pair of those cheap ass headphones from Delta so entitled kid could watch a Delta in-flight movie so patient man could have his tablet back. Entitled kid was a giant pest the entire flight, and finally, 3 hours in, patient man lost it when entitled kid said,
"Can I have a dollar?"
Patient man said, "I will give you $5 if you sit there and keep your freaking mouth shut the rest of the plane ride." Entitled kid knew he had reached the limit. His mom was snoring away happily. The plane lands, and she asked patient man if he wanted entitled kid's address so they could be pen pals. He said, "No, thank you." The person in the row behind them said,
"Listen, ma'am, I have an idea. Next time you fly, why don't you stay awake and do some parenting so some rando doesn't have to do it for you? Pack your kid some crap to keep him entertained so strangers don't have to do it for you."
She had this look of shock on her face that she couldn't understand that everyone in the world wasn't just completely enthralled and charmed by her little Caleb. It was a long flight, and wherever patient man is, if he reads this, I hope he knows how grateful a plane load of people are that it was him and not us next to that little moron and his idiot mother. Oh, and he refused to give entitled kid the $5. I saw this thing on the internet that airlines should implement this thing where it's like, hey, do you want to sit next to someone that is sociable, or do you want to, you know, not talk, or do you not care, or something like that, so they can kind of prioritize seating in a way that you have silence if you want it, or talking buddies if you want them, or if you don't care either way. So that stuff like this doesn't happen, because oh my god, I would dropkick that little snot like the little loogie that he is. I mean, not saying that I dropkick loogies, I'm just saying that you'd go flying, or he'd go flying like a loogie would. You know what I mean. This story's called
Worst Customer I Ever Had!
A few years ago, I worked at a restaurant slash bakery. I was the manager on duty one night, and we were slow, steady, not busy. A woman called in an order. One of my employees took it, rang it, and another one made it. I saw the woman come in for her food, saw her talking and smiling with the cashier, then I walked back to get something from the cooler. I came back up a few minutes later. Now, I did not know she was there to pick up the phone in order. I just knew the order had been there for a long while. I asked my employees about it. The cashier freaks and says,
"Oh no, she was just there. She left her food."
I asked how she could leave her food. The cashier said she bought something from the bakery and probably forgot because they were talking. Instead of waiting on the customer to call back angrily, I used the caller ID to call her back. She yelled at me and blamed us for her forgetting she had food. I told her if she came back for it, we would give her something for free. She said she used Uber to get there and doesn't know if she can get the driver back. I told her to try and let us know. Well, of course they didn't want to come back for free, she couldn't pay for another, and says she can't drag her kids out at this time of night. It was 7:30 p.m. She kept going on about how she would be a bad parent if she did so. She asked us to deliver. I told her we do not do that. Also, we closed at 9 p.m. and no one had a car but me, the manager, and I only had two other employees. She yelled and griped and blah blah blah. She said her kids needed to eat and they hadn't eaten anything. She said that she wasn't gonna send her kids to bed hungry and that they couldn't eat everything because they were vegetarians. I told her fine, we would take it to her in the next 30 minutes if possible. But then we got super busy in store because it was a weekend and the movies just let out. She called back repeatedly and I told her when I could take it, I would take it to her. Mind you, I am breaking company policy twice over because we don't offer this service, and I am leaving the store unattended. I finally remake her food upon her request and get in to drive to the address she gave. Mind you, the store is still busy, but my employees were tired of her too and said they could handle it. It is pitch black and past 8:30 p.m. when I pull up. The house has no lights on and looks intimidating. I saw a woman a few yards over with her kids, but didn't pay her much mind. I was calling her number, but it said the number was no longer in service. Turns out in my panic, I dialed the wrong area code. So with this mounting panic, dark neighborhood I have never been to, and the freaky phone number all of a sudden not working, I decided to leave. I would not endanger my life or anyone. I got back to the store. She called and said she was yelling at me from a few yards over. I told her I didn't hear her, especially not past the racket her kids were making, and I didn't feel comfortable where I was. She says she lives in a nice neighborhood where the homes cost so much and yada yada yada, so I shouldn't have felt unsafe. Be that as it may, I was not required to come out. You should have given me the correct address, and I did not feel safe. We can make it again next time you come. She was so unsatisfied, but could do nothing. She said it was the worst experience she had, and because of me, her kids wouldn't eat that night. It was too late for them to eat now, and even if I redelivered after we closed, they would be asleep. I called the owner and he said, don't go back there. I did all I could and don't give her the $25 gift card I was planning to surprise her with to shut her up. We would just discount her next meal. I said, okay, and ever since, I have never forgotten her face nor her order. She has never been a problem since because I always take over and make it. It's a super complicated order, and make sure she gets it before she leaves. But never again will I go above and beyond for someone like that. How do you go to a place with the sole purpose of picking up your order, then forgetting to pick up your order when you're there? Like, as if everything around you would not remind you that you have an order to pick up, that the reason you came there is still there, and she blames them. Uy. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell to never miss an episode.